Flutter 3.3 is out now. It's already available in the stable channel for use in a production environment. Flutter 3.3 continues and improves the developments that were already presented about 3 months ago, including many performance improvements, among which stands out the new Impeller engine that will eventually replace the rendering engine currently used by Flutter. As part of this release, the Flutter team has been working together with the G Skinner group on a new demo application that I'm showing you right now on the screen, which highlights the incredible animations and transitions that are possible with this magnificent framework. What you are seeing right now is a real iPhone running the Wonderous app, which I have downloaded directly from the Apple App Store. If you try the iOS version, you will see the new Impeller graphics engine, which is now available for iOS as a preview. In addition, the source code of this application is public, so you can see it and learn from it all you want. So that you can appreciate the change that Impeller is going to bring, I have tried to run this same application but with Skia, the current rendering engine. Look carefully at this animation and you will see the famous jank issue that causes some animations to drop the frame rate suddenly, especially the first time they are executed. Here you can see the unpleasant effect again. The reason this happens is that shaders, the pieces of code that sends instructions to the GPU, have to be compiled the first time they are run. Impeller solves this. The first thing I'm going to do is add this flag in info.plist to opt in to use Impeller. Now I'm going to run the same animation, and if you look carefully, you will see that it runs much more fluidly than before. Now I will run the other animation with the same effect. There is no longer a real-time compilation of top shaders, so the jank issue goes away. This technology looks quite promising and is going to solve this big problem that Flutter has historically had, especially on iOS and macOS. This new release of Flutter also brings news regarding the implementation of version 3 of Material, or Material U. Here you can see the sample app in the list of official samples. This app demonstrates the visual changes that our Flutter app will have once applied. Right now, if you create a Flutter app and you use the widgets from the Material collection, you will see their version 2. If you want to try Material 3, it's necessary to explicitly opt in. The initiative to bring Material 3 to Flutter compromises several points. There is an issue on GitHub where you can see its overall progress and the remaining points left to complete the project. To finish the video, I'm going to show you a couple of details that I found interesting. The first is that now we can use the Selection Area widget to be able to select several elements when dragging the mouse on a website. In this way, we can have a web behavior much more in line with traditional technologies. To use it, the only thing necessary is to wrap the target widget inside the selection area as I am showing you here. From this point, we can select the elements that are inside. Another important improvement is the enhancement of the trackpad input. If we go to the example indicated in the blog where this version of Flutter is announced, we will see how effectively the scroll response is when done with the trackpad of a laptop. It is more natural and feels more fluid. These are some of the improvements that Flutter 3.3 brings. I leave you in the description of this video the links to the official blog where you can see in much more detail everything mentioned here and the rest of the things that have been improved and added. I recommend that you take a look at it to get a better view of this new version. Thank you very much for watching this summary of Flutter 3.3. Please leave a like and consider subscribing for more content related to Flutter. Thank you for watching and have a great rest of your day.